Revelation 11. I think a very interesting chapter, Revelation, which we are seeing to be fulfilled by all what is happening in Israel. What is happening in Israel is that they are also already designing the third temple according to the description given in Ezekiel. If you go to the text of my website, you will find there several links to YouTube's video about the design of the third temple. Also about that one is already training the priest Israel to perform their priesthood. A video about where might be the Ark of the Covenant, and already they started 5 years ago with the creation of the Red Heifer, and 5 years later they are now testing if these two heifers, red heifers, are blameless and they are ready to breed so that it can be fulfilled, the sacrifices. We are clearly in the end of our days. The Great Tribulation will start soon, and the third temple we will be built. So the third temple will be built soon after the rapture of the church. All preparations are nowadays in progress, and 1 Kings 14:25-26 tells us, in the fifth year of King Rehoboam, Siskiya, king of Egypt, came up against Jerusalem. He took away the treasures of the house of the Lord and the treasures of the king's house. He took away everything, but it is told by the Jews that not the Ark of the Covenant was taken. It is said that Jeremiah hid the Ark of the Covenant. And we have 2 Maccabees 2:4-8. When Jeremiah arrived there, he found a chamber in a cave in which he put the tent, the ark, and the altar of incense, and then he sealed the entrance. Some of those who followed him came up with the intention to mark the path, but they couldn't find it. When Jeremiah heard about this, he reproved these people. The place is to remain unknown until God gathers his people together again and shows them mercy. Then the Lord, God the Father, Jesus Christ, will disclose these things, and the glory of the Lord, the cloud, will be seen, just as they appeared in the time of Moses and of Salomo, when he prayed that the place might be greatly sanctified. We do not know where the Ark of the Covenant is hidden. It might be in Jerusalem. Some say it is in Egypt. Others say it is in Ethiopia. But we can be sure that when the temple is rebuilt in Jerusalem, they have found the Ark of the Covenant and will be placed in the Holy of Holies. And let us look at what Numbers 19:1-2 tells us about the red heifer. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "This is the statue of the Lord, which the Lord has commanded. Tell the people of Israel to bring a red heifer without defect, in which there is no blemish, and upon which a yoke has never come." So, let us start with Revelation 11. "Then I, John, was given a measuring rod like a staff, and I was told, 'Rise and measure the temple of God and the altar and those who worship there. But do not measure the court outside the temple. Leave that out.'" So John is told clearly to measure the temple. The temple, which is now being designed, the government of Israel still forbids to take the stones to the place where they think the first temple was. And let us look very carefully, because the Muslim people claim that the Dome Rock is built on the place where the first temple was. But they are wrong. Look what is written in verse 2. "Do not measure the court outside the temple. Leave that out, for it is given over to the nations." The Dome Rock is outside the temple. They already discovered where is the exact place where the first temple was, and that is not where the Dome Rock is built. The Dome Rock is in the foreyard of the temple. So they can easily build the temple on the exact place, and the Dome Rock will be in the front yard. So, no problems. Revelation 11 is sure. It will surely happen. We are in the final time. The things are preparing. The Jewish people have returned to Israel. They are doing all the preparations to build. They are training the priests. They have the red heifers. So, and also they have the Tanakh of pure gold. It is already ready. So, just waiting for the rapture of the church and the great tribulation to start with the building of the temple in Jerusalem. Daniel 9 verse 27 tells us that he, Satan, the beast, shall make a strong government for 1 week, 7 years. He will bring the peace in Jerusalem, in Israel. The temple will be quickly built, but for half of the week, that's after 3.5 years, he shall cause the sacrifice and offering to cease. Written is here, meaning the 42 months, 1260 days, the nations will tremble over the holy city, Jerusalem. Then the two witnesses will prophesy for 1260 days, 3.5 years, clothed in sackcloth. This cloth was the usual garb of prophets. You can read that in 2 Kings 1 verse 8 and Isaiah 20 verse 2. So, if you are interested, you can go to YouTube or internet and type the Red Heifer, the temple in Jerusalem, type the Ark of the Covenant, and you will find there very much information about what is going on in the preparation for the Great Tribulation. So, the two witnesses, they will prophesy for 3.5 years. And I think this is the second half of the Great Tribulation. So, who are those two witnesses? Some say that it is Enoch, because he hasn't seen death, because God had taken him, Hebrew 11 verse 5, but Enoch, he was taken because he was righteousness. He obeyed and followed God perfectly, and that was the reason why he was taken by God. He didn't perform any miracles. So, most likely it will not be Enoch. So, who are those two witnesses? Well, most people think they are Moses and Elijah. They sinned during their life, but those two didn't see death. Moses was buried by God, Deuteronomy 34 verses 5 and 6, and the angel Michael, contending with the devil, disputed about the body of Moses. So clearly Moses was alive. You can read that in Jude verse 9. Elijah, he went up by a whirlwind into heaven by a chariot of fire and horses. You can read that in 2 Kings 2 verse 11. Moses and Elijah were the two persons who appeared on the Mount of Transfiguration talking with Jesus. Matthew 17, verse 3. There the three disciples of Jesus were shown the kingdom of God. So they are related clearly to the kingdom of God. And Moses, he demonstrated the power of God in doing the 10 plagues in Egypt. Pharaoh didn't wish to listen. Familiar? Nowadays to the people, despite the demonstrations with all the distractions, the COVID, they are not willing to listen and give God the honor and repent. Many Christians, they do not return anymore to the church. They are afraid to get the virus, the infection is, they tell it is better to release the people so that the immune system will fight, but many do not return to the church, and many do not read the Bible, do not pray, nor take the Holy Supper at home. So we don't need to be surprised that Pharaoh was stubborn and Moses changed the water of the river into blood. So what is written here, we don't need to be surprised. What is written in verse 6, they have power over the waters to turn them into blood. And a liar, he had the power over the rain, over the dew. 1 Kings 17 verse 1. So verse 6, they have power to set the sky that no rain may fall during the day of the prophecy. So, according to me, it is fairly clearly that these two witnesses are Moses and Elijah. Elijah also, when we read 2 Kings 1 verse 10 to 12, also let fire came from heaven to consume the disrespectful soldiers and the commander. Nobody is able to fight them. If they wish to do harm to them, then fire comes out of their mouth and consume their enemies. Don't laugh. Fire coming out of the mouth of a person. Well, they are representative of God, and God will give them the power. So don't be stubborn and believe what is written over here. So what will they proclaim? They will proclaim the kingdom of God. They will proclaim that one need to say no to the beast, no to Satan, no to the false prophet. God is showing his power, that he is control. These two prophets have been given the power by God not to rain, to turn rivers into blood, that fire consume the enemies. So God is proving that he exists and is in control. After 3.5 years of the preaching of these two witnesses, God releases the beast from the bottomless pit, and he fight against these two witnesses. God gives this beast with a sense from the bottomless pit to overcome them and kill them. Everybody on earth is rejoicing. Finally, an end to all these plagues. No rain and rivers turn into blood. And the bodies are disposed in the great city, Jerusalem, the city where Jesus Christ was crucified. Hello! And they are sending presents to one another and they are rejoicing. Only they didn't count on the power of God and this rejoicing and pleasure and feasting takes only 3.5 days. And then God shows his power. Like he has risen his son Jesus Christ after 3 days from the death, he also breathed into these two witnesses and they came alive. For 3.5 days, people on earth were seeing their bodies, they weren't buried, the whole world could see it. And nowadays, with television, internet, YouTube, and other social media, we don't need to be surprised that the whole world is able to see it. And while they are rejoicing, fear comes after 3.5 days, and the world is watching through television and social media that they come alive. And they see that God is taking them into heaven. God is demonstrating his power. They will be in shock and some will acknowledge God, but others they remain stubborn and continue to follow the beast. So, what will happen? Well, after they are taken up by God, a tremendous great earthquake occurred in Jerusalem. A tenth of Jerusalem is destroyed. We don't need to be surprised about that earthquake, because Israel is seismically active, located along the Syrian-African fault line. This runs along the Israeli-Jordan border, part of the Great Rift Valley, running from eastern Lebanon to Sambosidi. So we don't need to be surprised about that great earthquake. Come back to that later. So, the first and second Wu has passed. Behold, the third Wu is soon to come, is written in Revelation 11:14. We are getting interval. Some things need to be explained. So, we continue in verse 15. Then the seventh angel blew his trumpet. Why then after those two wolves, I don't know. And there were loud voices in heaven saying, the kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. I cannot explain this. What I see it in my way is that during 42 months, the last 42 months, so if this occurred in the first half, what I just explained to you, I do not know. I think it is in the last, but in Revelation 13 verse 5 is stated, and 3.5 years of the reign of the Antichrist remains, and during those, or at the end of those 3.5 years, I think the seventh angel blows his trumpet and continues the plagues in Revelation 16 of the seven bowls. So, So how this time, how we need to interpret that, I cannot explain that exactly to you, but we must listen and understand the plagues. That is the warning. Not the exact time period. That isn't important. Important is that people do not reject God and listen to what is preached by these two witnesses and how they show the power of God. The people on earth get the chance to decide before Satan, the beast, or before God. And if rejecting God, they will experience the wrath of God and experience the plagues of those seven bowls in Revelation 16. So here the 24 elders worship God because they know that the kingdom is coming and God will fulfill his promises. Then God's temple in heaven, verse 19, was opened and the ark of his covenant was seen within his temple. Don't be surprised that there is a temple, an ark of the covenant in heaven, because we read in Hebrews 8, the verses 5 and 6, Moses was instructed to build the tabernacle according to the model which he has seen in heaven. So there is a temple and a tabernacle and Ark of Covenant in heaven. And the last sentences of verse 19, and there were flashes of lightning, like noises, peals of thunder, and earthquake, and heavy rain. Well, this is completely in accordance what Ezekiel already had seen, Ezekiel 38, the verses 19 to 22. So it was already prophesied, here it is repeated, so we can be sure it will happen in the Great Tribulation. When exactly? Perhaps you are able to figure it out, but the important thing is that you accept Jesus Christ and that you will not pass through this Great Tribulation, but you will be taken up at the rapture of the church. Tell your friends, tell your neighbors, explain it so the videos of me to your colleagues, make known, subscribe to my channel on YouTube, follow me, and I will continue to explain Revelation. Let it be a warning, take it serious, don't laugh about it. That's too marvelous, because already this was written 2000 years ago, and now 2000 years later, all the preparations are going on for the preparation of the temple, the red heifers, the training of the priests, and soon will be discovered the location of the Ark of the Covenant. So we can be sure, without any doubt, that what is written here will be fulfilled. Take it to heart.